Welcome to an example on how to use the one variable statistics tool on the T84 graphing calculator. In this video, we'll look at an example where we also have a frequency table. When we run the one variable statistics on the T84, we're able to get all the information about the data shown here, where x bar is equal to the mean or average, the sum of x is equal to the sum of the data values, the sum of x squared is equal to the sum of the squares of the data values, Sx is the sample standard deviation, sigma x is the population standard deviation, n equals the number of data values. On the next page, min x is the minimum data value, q1 is the first quartile, med is the median, q3 is the third quartile, and max x is the maximum data value. It's important to note, though, that there are several methods for determining the first and third quartiles. So before using these, we do want to make sure we're supposed to use the method used by the T84 graphing calculator. And for my research, I found that the T84 graphing calculator uses the formula 0.25 times the quantity n plus 1 to calculate the position of the lower quartile, and 0.75 times the quantity n plus 1 to calculate the position of the upper quartile, or quartile 3. And the calculators return the average position between the measurements instead of the exact position or rounding to a particular position used in some stat software packages if the position is a decimal. Another way to explain how the T84 calculator finds the quartiles would be to say that the lower quartile, or Q1, is the median of the lower half of the data. The upper quartile, or Q3, is the median of the upper half of the data. However, if the median is the data value, it is not considered to be in the upper or lower half of the data. So looking at these two examples where we have an even number of data values, notice how the median here would be 14, and here we'd have a median of 15.5. In these two examples, the median is not a data value, and therefore Q1 is the mean of 7 and 9, which is 8, and Q3 would be the mean or average of 16 and 20, which is 18. In this example, the median of the lower half would be 9, so Q1 is 9, and Q3 would be the median of the upper half, or 24. Now let's look at two examples where we have an odd number of data values. Because we have an odd number of data values, notice how the median is a data value both here and here, so the TI does not consider it in the upper or lower half. And therefore Q1 is going to be the mean or average of 7 and 9, which is 8, and Q3 is going to be the average of 20 and 24, which is 22. Here though, because we have an odd number of data values in the lower and upper half, because TI does not consider the median in the upper or lower half, Q1 is 9 and Q3 is 26. This is important to recognize because if your course does not use the same technique in order to find the quartiles, you don't want to rely on the 84 to find the quartiles for you. And in fact, in our class, we actually are not using the same method that the TI84 does. We use the method outlined here. But let's go ahead and take a look at an example where we use the TI84.
We're asked to determine the mean, median, sample and population standard deviation, and the five-number summary. Normally, we would not find both the sample and population standard deviation. If the data was a sample, we'd use only the sample standard deviation. If the data was the entire population, we would only use the population standard deviation. For the first step, let's enter the data. So we'll enter the data values in L1 and the frequency in L2. Notice because 65 has a frequency of 2, there are two data values of 65. Because the frequency of 73 is 3, there are three data values of 73, and so on. So we'll press STAT and then Enter. Because we have old data in L1, we'll go to the top of the column, press Clear, and then Enter. And now we'll enter the data values. So we have 65, Enter, 73, Enter, and so on. And now we'll press the right arrow and enter the frequency. So 2, enter, 3, enter, and so on. And now we'll run the one variable statistics. So we'll press the STAT key, right arrow once to calculate, and the first option is one variable statistics. So you can either press number 1 or enter because 1 is highlighted. So we'll press enter. Now I have a newer version of the TI84. I'll show the screen for the older version in just a moment. Notice here it's asking for list, Our data is in L1, so this is correct. We'll press the down arrow. The frequency list, though, is in L2, so we want to enter L2 by pressing second number 2, arrow down to calculate, and press enter. And before we gather the information that we need, I do want to show the screenshot from the older version of the 84 or the 83. Once we have one var statistics on the home screen using the older version, we need to select the list for the data values and the list for the frequency. So notice here, the data was in L1, so we select L1 by pressing second 1, comma, and then enter second 2 for L2 to indicate where the frequency is located. And then from here, we would just press enter. Which brings us to this screen. So this tells us X bar, the mean, would be approximately 82.36. From this screen, we also see that the sample standard deviation would be approximately 8.59, and the population standard deviation would be approximately, notice we rounded 2 decimal places, rounding up, so to 2 decimal places this would be approximately 8.40. So our mean would be approximately 82.36, the sample standard deviation is approximately 8.59, and the population standard deviation was approximately 8.40. Now I'll press a down arrow to go to the next page. Notice how the median is equal to 81. And then the five number summary is going to be the min, Q1, the median, Q3, and the max. So we have 65, 81, 81, 88, 95. And again, just remember, there are several methods to determine Q1 and Q3. So before we use these values, it's important to make sure you're supposed to use the same method as the TI84. And remember, for our class, we are using a different method. I hope you found this helpful.